too much. Primary brown tumors are very rare. Osteosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, fibrosarcoma are primary bone tumors of bone. They rarely present as a multifocal disease. You can see in this diagram, the sites of different types of bone tumors are shown. Multiple malignant lesions usually indicate metastatic disease. So, coming to clinical presentation, there will be a painless bony mass. That means it's usually benign. If there is painful bony mass, it's usually malignant. If there is soft tissue mass, it's a feature of malignant and aggressive lesion. Sometimes bone tumors are presented as an incidental finding, or they present as a pathological fracture. Coming to classification of bone tumors, there are different types of bone tumors. First type is bone forming. What do you mean by bone forming? It's osteogenetic. So examples are osteoma, osteoblastoma. These are benign tumors. And in malignant type, it's a osteosarcoma. Second type is cartilage forming, that is chondrogenic. That spelling is not correct. Benign examples are chondroma, osteochondroma, chondromyxoid fibroma, and malignant examples are chondrosarcoma and clear cell chondroma. Next type is giant cell tumors. Example benign is classical GCT. GCT is giant cell tumor. And in malignant, malignant GCT. Then comes marrow tumors. Usually they are malignant. Examples are Ewing sarcoma, reticulosarcoma, lymphosarcoma, or myeloma. Next type is vascular tumors. Examples are hemangioma, lymphangioma, and glomus tumor. These are benign. Whereas malignant example is angiosarcoma. Next type is connective tissue tumors. Benign examples are desmoplastic fibroma, lipoma, whereas malignant examples are fibrosarcoma, liposarcoma, malignant mesenchymoma, undifferentiated sarcoma. In other tumors, examples are chondroma, adamantiomanoma, neurelimoma, and neurofibroma. There are certain tumor-like lesions, like solitary bone cyst, aneurysmal bone cyst, juxta-articular bone cyst, metaphyllic fibrous defects, fibrous dysplasia, myositis ossificans, and brown tumor. So these are the common benign tumors of the bone. First is osteoma, then comes osteoid osteoma, osteoblastoma, enchondroma, osteochondroma, and multiple hereditary exostosis, chondromyxoid fibroma, chondroblastoma, benign giant cell tumor, aneurysmal bone cyst, unicameral bone cyst, non-ossifying fibroma, and fibrous dysplasia. These are examples of common benign tumors of bone. Now we'll see some common benign tumors of the bone. First is osteoma. And osteoma is a benign, uncommon lesion, slowly growing tumor occurring in membranous bones of skull and face. Age, children and adolescents. Its common sites are frontal and facial bones externally, maybe intranasal, intraorbital. They give certain signs and symptoms. Sometimes they doesn't produce any symptoms. Intracranial osteoma may cause headache and epileptic seizures. Intraorbital may produce exophthalmos. Its pathology is dense compact bone covered by fibrous tissue capsule, continuous with periosteum. X-ray picture, you can see osteoid composed of semicircular, extremely dense, sharply outlined nature cortical bone. There is little or no reactive bone formation. Prognosis. Once it reaches certain size, it remains stationary. It does not undergo malignant change. Its treatment is excision, but it is indicated for diagnostic and cosmetic purpose, or when there is signs which are troublesome, then only you think of excision. Second commonest benign tumor is osteoid osteoma. This is benign osteoblastic tumor with a well-demarcated nidus of less than 1.5 centimeter, surrounded by a distinct reactive bone. Its incidence is 2.6% of all primary bone tumors. It is common in the age group of 10 to 25 years. Male-female ratio is 3:1. Site. Long bones, usually tibia and femur, mostly commonly affected. Sometimes you get these types of tumor in posterior element of spine. Coming to clinical feature of osteoid osteoma, vague and intermittent pain, more at night, pain relieved by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. This is a characteristic of osteoid osteoma. The pain is relieved by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Mild swelling, tenderness present, vertebral scoliosis, sometimes you come across in the clinical feature. This pathology is vascular mesenchymal type of connective tissue stroma with proliferate fibroblasts and osteoblasts, surrounds abundant pink staining osteoid tissue cartilage. Osteoid tissue cartilage is not found. on plain film means X-ray, cortical, cancellous, medullary, subperiosteal, or periarticular, that is intracapsular. Small and round radiolucent center with surrounding sclerosis. So in this X-ray, you can see cortical thickening, and in the lower end, you can see incidental osteoid osteoma. Sometimes it can be diagnosed on, you can do bone scan. It's called as double density sign. Treatment is wide en bloc resection with removal of surrounding sclerotic bone. Third common type is osteoblastoma. Benign osseous tumor, usually more than 2 cm in diameter, histologically similar to osteoid osteoma, but has different natural history. Age groups, highest incidence in the first 3 decades. Male-female ratio is 2:1. Most common site is distal femur, in contrast with osteoma, which is more common in proximal femur. Diaphysis, that is 75% in 75% it presents in diaphysis. Sometimes it presents in metaphysis of long bones. Sometimes you can see osteoid blastoma in the spine, typically in posterior elements, that is pedicles, primary in lumbar and thoracic regions. It is rarely found in foot and pelvis. You can compare osteoblastoma versus osteoid osteoma. Osteoblastoma occurs in older adolescents and young adults. Osteoblastoma usually does not cause localized night pain, and when pain occurs, usually not relieved by salicylates, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. So in osteoid osteoma, we have seen that pain is relieved by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. But in this type of benign tumor, osteoblastoma, the pain is not relieved by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Intense bony reaction seen with osteoid osteoma does not occur with osteoblastoma. So intense bony reaction means surrounded sclerosis, which is present in osteoid osteoma, not in osteoblastoma. Osteoblastoma more often located in posterior elements of vertebrae. Osteoblastoma do not resolve spontaneously, but the treatment is same, wide en bloc resection. Coming to enchondromas, a benign chondrogenic lesion caused by an abnormality of chondroblast function in the pelvis. It is seen in the age group of 10 to 60 years. Common sites are, it occurs in medullary cavity, in diaphysis or metaphysis of long bones. Hand is most common location, that is 60% enchondromas occur in hand. commonly present as a pathological fracture. Other locations include femur, that is 20%, and proximal humerus in 10% of cases. Enchondromas includes solitary enchondroma, 1% chance of malignant transformation into chondrosarcoma in this type of enchondroma, solitary enchondroma. Then Olier's disease, multiple enchondromatosis, multiple osteochondromas in diaphysis of long bones, 10 to 30% chance of malignant transformation into chondrosarcoma. So it is more, means malignant transformation is greater than solitary endochondromas in Olier disease. Third is Maffucci's syndrome, multiple enchondromas and soft tissue angiomas. There is 100% chance of malignant transformation into chondrosarcoma. There is increased risk of visceral malignancies like astrocytoma and GI malignancy. So most in Maffucci's syndrome, the malignant transformation is almost of 100%. Its presentation, most are asymptomatic, often present as pathological fracture of hand or foot. Enchondroma may disrupt the growth plate and lead to shortening and angular deformities. Radiological features are popcorn calcification, stippled rings in diaphyseal or metaphyseal medullary cavities. Coming to treatment, sometimes you can treat it conservatively by observing serial X-rays to be taken, and if they are more symptomatic, then you can go for curettage with bone grafting. That is operative treatment. Next type is osteochondroma and multiple hereditary exostosis. It is a developmental lesion which starts as a small overgrowth of cartilage. The edge of the epiphyseal plate is common site and develops by endochondral ossification into bony protuberance still covered by the cap of cartilage. It is the most common benign bone tumor. True incidence is unknown as many are asymptomatic. It's common in adolescents and young adults, occur in metaphysis of any bone preformed in cartilage. Common locations are distal femur, proximal tibia, and proximal humerus. Sometimes you can see these type of tumors in iliac crest. Subungual exostosis occurs most often at hallux. What is hallux? It's a great toe. And that is first metatarsal. The lesion may go on growing, but at the end of the normal growth period, that bone, it stops enlarging. presentation of osteochondroma only present with painless mass. So patient just notices the bony swelling, but is painless. May have mechanical symptoms or symptoms of neurovascular compression. Occasionally, there is pain due to an overlying bursa or impingement of soft tissue. Or rarely, paresthesia due to stretching of an adjacent nerve. This can be multiple in number. Often presents with limb deformities. Multiple exostoses often present with limb deformities and groin dysmenorrhea. Often presents with limb deformities and growth disturbances. In short, stretcher, deformed joints, and decreased range of movement. Most common sites of deformity include the knee, foot, and ankle. Upper extremity deformities are well tolerated and lead to little loss of function. Radiography. Sessile, that is broad-based, or pedunculated, that is narrow stalk-based lesions, are found on the surface of bones. Higher risk of malignant degeneration is in sessile type of lesions, that is broad-based lesions. Pedunculated lesions grow away from the involved joint. Cortex of the lesion is continuous with the cortex of the bone. Cavity of the lesion is continuous with the medullary cavity, and cartilaginous cap is radiolucent. Treatment, osteochondromas. Most of the time, observation alone in asymptomatic cases. If it is a symptomatic lesion, then go for operative treatment. Marginal resection, including cartilage cap, is indicated if patient is symptomatic. If there are no symptoms, then surgery is delayed until skeletal maturity. Multiple hereditary exostoses. Treatment is non-operative. Most patients do not require intervention prior to reaching skeletal maturity. Operative procedure is simple excision, optimizes chance of improved range of motion. This is another type of benign lesion, chondromyxoid fibroma. I think you can go through the details. We'll go to the next type. Coming to next common important bone tumor is benign GCT. It is an osteolytic lesion arising from epiphysis, common in young adults. Incidence is 5%. Age distribution is 20 to 40 years in 70% of cases. Common sites are epiphyseal region of long bones, then pelvis and sacrum. Pathologically, soft tumor, very friable, readily bleeding tissue. It contains cavitation and small cysts. Color of tumor varies from reddish to chocolate brown. Presence of abundant tumor giant cell is characteristic. Presence of spindle cells indicate malignant potential. Its clinical features are chronic, coarse swelling, pain, pathological fracture. egg cell crackling sensation is characteristic. On X-ray, cortex is expanded and thin. It's an osteolytic lesion. You know osteolytic word, in which bone is broken down. What do you mean by osteogenic? New bone formation is there. Here is a osteolytic lesion. So normal bone structure is destroyed with no periosteal new bone formation. Thin septa of bone traverse the interior and produce soap bubble appearance. So a soap bubble appearance is a characteristic X-ray feature of benign GCT. Its treatment is curettage and bone grafting. Curettage has recurrence of 85%. Without bone grafting, recurrence is curettage has recurrence of 85%. And with bone grafting, recurrence is 40%. So curettage and bone grafting is preferred. इनको ये करेंगे क्या? अनम्यूट ऑल किया है ना? हाँ. अच्छा ठीक है. म्यूट ऑल है. हाँ रहने दो. Second treatment is N-block excision. It is reserved for aggressive tumors. Third treatment is curettage and acrylic cementation. It has got least recurrence. Fourth treatment is curettage and cryosurgery. Fifth is radiation therapy. But it itself causes malignant changes if given to a benign tumor. Then why you include it in this? Okay. Next benign tumor is aneurysmal bone cyst. It's a benign lesion, eccentrically located in metaphysis. Incidence is 1%. It's more common in the group of 10 to 30 years. It's common in both sex equally. More common sites are femur, tibia, humerus, rarely vertebra. Can I see students' remarks? Am I audible? Nobody is asking anything. They can ask, na?
They can ask.
But how to see? How? What is going on? So coming to aneurysmal bone cyst, common sites are femur, tibia, humerus, rarely vertebra. Something is wrong. हाँ तो तुमच्या नेटचा प्रॉब्लेम आहे. डायरेक्ट लावा की लॅन नाही आहे. डायरेक्ट क्यों
नहीं ना पिन
क्या है
तो स्पीड मिलता है
स्पीड का इश्यू नहीं है.
It's on. Sorry for the disturbance, some technical issues. Sorry, friends. There was some technical problem. Aneurysmal bone cyst is mistaken for malignant tumor due to great rate of growth and destruction of bone. Clinical features include it presents can present as a pathological fracture with pain and swelling. Its treatment is curettage and bone grafting. 50% recurrence rate is there. In cases of recurrent tumors, total excision is advised. Right. Here comes next is unicameral bone cyst. It's uncommon, non-neoplastic. Osteolytic lesion in metafascial areas. It's of two types. One is active cyst close to growth plate with high recurrence rate. Second is latent cyst is away from growth plate, is less recurrent. Incidence is 3%, age is below 10 years of age in 50% cases, 10 to 20 years of age in 40% cases, male-female ratio is 2:1. Its location is upper end of humerus, upper end of femur. Its pathology is periosteum is lifted and underlying bone is eggshell thin. It's semi-translucent, easily penetrable single cavity, contains yellow fluid. Its clinical features are asymptomatic, may present as a pathological fracture, or pain, growth disturbances, spontaneous obliteration is known. X-ray features, fallen fragment sign when phalen fragment sign when pathological fracture occurs. Please find out what is phalen fragment sign. I'm not getting it. Its treatment is curettage and bone grafting. High rate of recurrence in this. Total excision treatment is treatment of choice. Intracystic prednisolone may obliterate small bone cysts. Next come non-ossifying fibroma. It's a metaphyseal fibrous defect, silent small fibrous lesion, 2 to 3 mm in dimension, millimeters in dimension, common developmental lesion in children in metaphysis, cause thinning of cortex. Usually disappears within a few years, rarely few enlarged to 4 to 5 centimeters with increased fibroproliferative activity. It erodes marrow and cortex. Next is non-ossifying fibroma. I think you can remember all this. Then we'll come to common malignant tumors, which is very rare, 1% of total tumors. Osteosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, chondrosarcoma, fibrosarcoma, malignant GCT, histiocytic lymphoma, liposarcoma, adamantioma, adamantinoma, and chordoma. So we'll see some of the malignant tumors. First is multiple myeloma, most common primary malignant bone tumor. It is 40% of primary bone tumor. Male-female ratio is 2:1. Its peak at 7th decade. Etiology. Many a times, etiology is not known. Etiology of unknown origin. It commonly seen in farmers, woodworkers, leather workers, and those exposed to petroleum products. Chromosomal abnormalities are there. Pathogenesis. Plasma cell, terminally differentiated cell of B cell linkage. Clonal neoplastic plasma cell transformation. Overproduction of single antibody that appears in plasma, that is M protein. This clonal plasma cell activates osteoclasts by release of chemokines. It is also associated with increased generation of osteoclasts from monocyte precursors. Skeletal distribution is ribs, skull, pelvis, long bones, spine. In long bones, metaphysis. In spine, body of vertebra. In this figure, you can see healthy bone marrow and bone marrow with multiple myeloma. DNA damage causes damage white blood cell, that is B cell, which causes multiple myeloma cell with M protein. Pathological features: gross marrow is replaced by soft gelatinous reddish gray or fleshy white tissue. Histopathologically, atypical plasma cells replacing normal fatty and hematopoietic marrow. Its clinical features are bone pain, which is dull aching, intermittent, mostly localized to lower back, upper spine, pelvis, ribs, and sternum. Persistent pain indicates pathological fractures. Bony lesions may expand and may be palpable, especially on skull, clavicle, and sternum. It is susceptible to infection. Sometimes you can see renal failure, renal failure due to hypercalcemia, bone joint splitting, and amyloidosis. Anemia is present. Clotting abnormalities can be seen. Raynaud's phenomenon is seen. Hyperviscosity and constitutional symptoms. Investigations are urine for BJ proteins, CBC, bone scan, bone marrow examination. It can be done. The common sites are sternum and iliac crest. Serum protein electrophoresis, cytogenetics, X-rays, CT scan, and MRI. Examine multiple myeloma. Generalized reduction in bone density. Localized arc of radiolucency, skull, raindrop lesion, punched out lytic lesions, marked bone expansion, ballooned appearance. In spine, collapse of vertebral bodies, multiple level compression fractures. This is X-ray of skull and spine. This is X-ray of upper end of femur. This is pelvis, punched out osteoporotic lesions. Treatment is chemotherapy, bone marrow transplant, corticosteroids, melphalan, that is alkylating agent, and plasmapheresis. Orthopedic treatment is treatment of impending or actual pathological fracture of spine, acetabulum, proximal femur, or proximal humerus. Open reduction and internal fixation with packing of cavities with bone cement. Spine fracture needs stabilization.